This episode is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform that makes it fast and easy to create your own professional website or online portfolio. It's incredibly easy to use, and they have over 20 highly customizable, beautiful templates to choose from. For a free trial and 20% off during the month of September, head over to squarespace.com and enter coupon code ICEFLOW9. Thanks to Squarespace for helping keep my content completely free for all of you. I'm going to show you how you can not only add... Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with a Lightroom tutorial, just to mix things up a little bit. In the past, I've gone through Photoshop tutorials on how to add watermarks to your images, whether it be using actions or otherwise, but I've never covered this subject in Lightroom. And not surprisingly, because Lightroom focuses on photography, adding watermarks to your images is not only very easy, but also very customizable. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can not only add a text-based watermark, but an image watermark as well. Let's take a look. So here I am in Lightroom with a bunch of images that I'm going to use in my portfolio. Now, just to start off, I am not a fan of watermarks. Whenever I upload my images to Facebook or Google+, I tend not to add watermarks because it just distracts people. But from a business standpoint, if you're a photographer whose main goal is to drive people back to your website, you may want to add a watermark. So I'm going to show you how this can be done. The first step is to set up your watermark. If you go to the top of your application, right to the menu bar, you click on Lightroom, and then you go to Edit Watermarks. This is where you'll be able to set up and create a brand new watermark, and you have two options. You can choose to create a text-based watermark or a graphical watermark. Let's start with text. Now, right now, what you're looking at is pretty much a transparent canvas. And that's because no images were selected. So I'm going to cancel out of this just so we can get a preview of how things are going to look. I'm going to click on my first image, hold down my shift key, and then click on this image down here just to select a few images, just so we can use them as a preview. So once again, I'm going to head back up to the menu bar, go to Edit Watermarks, and now you'll see that we can now see the watermark on top of our image. And using the left or right arrows at the top, I can cycle through all the selected images. So I'm going to leave it at that one because I can really see the watermark nice and clear. Now, as I currently have text selected, right at the bottom, you have the option of changing the text that displays on your watermark. In this case, by default, it's going to add a copyright symbol and my name right beside it. But of course, you can select this and type anything you like. If you have a website you want to direct people to, you can type that. I can type ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com if I wanted to. But for this case, I'm going to leave it as copyright Howard Pinsky. Maybe I'll even add 2013 right at the end of it, just to keep it nice and simple. Now over to the right, we have our watermark properties. First, we can select what kind of font we want to use. You can go crazy and select an unreadable script, or you can select something very basic like Helvetica, which if you've watched my tutorials before, you know I love Helvetica. So I'm going to set it at bold, just like that. You can see the preview is updating live at the bottom left corner of our image. And you also have alignment and color options. Now your alignment options don't dictate which side of the image your watermark appears on. This is there if you have multiple lines in your watermark. For instance, if I put ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com on the second line, I can either align my watermark to the left, center, or right. And then you have the option to set a color using a color picker right down below. I'm going to keep it at white to keep things very simple. Now the next option is shadow. Now here you can either turn shadow off completely, or you can keep shadow on and then adjust the properties right here. You have the opacity of the shadow, how strong it is. I'm going to leave it around 55%. You have your offset, which basically controls how far out from the text your shadow is. So if I pull that outwards, you may notice, you may not notice, that the shadow is pulling further away from the text as I increase the offset. I'm going to leave it somewhere around 25. And then you have the radius and angle values to control the spread and which direction the shadow is going. So right now it's negative 90, which would be going downwards. Now it may be difficult to see because the watermark is so small, but we'll be able to change that in the next section. So down below, right under watermark effects, you can first control the opacity of the watermark. So if you want it to be a little bit more transparent, you can decrease the opacity so you can see right through to the image behind it. Right around 40% is nice. And then you have your size control. Now this is really cool because in Photoshop, if you're adding watermarks using an action, unless you really create that action well, there's a good chance that your watermark may appear bigger or smaller depending on the image that you're working with. So by keeping the size at proportional, your watermark is always going to be sized relative to the size of your document, no matter if your image is 4x6 or 18x20, and you can control that size using this slider right here. As I slide to the right, my watermark gets larger, and as I slide to the left, it gets smaller. So I'm going to leave it right around there. Now you do have two other options. You have Fit, and then you have Fill. Fit will enlarge your watermark as large as it can go, but at the same time, making sure that you can see the whole watermark on your image. And then Fill, well, you get the idea. You probably don't want to do that unless you're a stock photographer, and you really want to protect that image so no one steals it. In this case, I'm going to choose proportional and leave it somewhere around 15. Now the next section allows you to inset the watermark. Right now it's at the bottom left-hand corner and it's right on the edges. I probably don't want that, so I'm going to increase the horizontal inset a little bit, somewhere around 3, and then the vertical inset as well, just to pull that watermark away from the edge. And finally, down below you have your anchor points and your rotation. The anchor points are where you can instruct Lightroom where to place the watermark. Right now it's at the bottom left corner, but I can very easily place it at the top left, the top right, the bottom right, or anywhere in between just by clicking on those little radio buttons. I'm going to keep it at the bottom left. And finally you have rotation. If you want to rotate it 90 degrees clockwise or counterclockwise, you can very easily do so by clicking on the arrows. So that's a text-based watermark. Very simple and very effective at the same time. Now to save this watermark, head over to the drop-down menu, click on Custom, and then Save Current Settings as New Preset. I'm going to name this one HP Text, and then press Create to save that watermark. So now under my presets, I now have my text-based watermark right there for me whenever I need it. And you're going to see in a second how you can use these when exporting your images. Now finally, let's go ahead and create a graphic watermark. I'm going to click on the graphic radio button, and up comes my file browser where I can find my watermark, which I created in Photoshop and saved as a transparent PNG. I'm going to press choose, and you're going to notice Lightroom has placed that watermark at the bottom left corner of my image. And then if we scroll down over to the right, we have many of the same options we had when creating a text-based watermark. We can control the opacity. For this one, I'm going to increase it just a little bit. We can choose how we want it sized on our image. Again, proportional will keep the watermark looking the same on all of your images. You can fit or you can fill it as well. I'm going to keep it at proportional. And then you can control the horizontal and vertical inset, the anchor, and the rotation as well. And just like you did before, if you want to save it, head up to the drop-down, choose Save Current Settings as New Preset, and I'm going to name this one ICEFLOW Logo and press Create. So now we've created both our watermarks. We have our text-based watermark and we have our logo. So how do we go about using them? I'm going to go ahead and press Done. And there are a few places within Lightroom that you can use these watermarks. Whether you're creating a web gallery, a slideshow, a book, a print, or you're simply just exporting these images to your computer. So I'm going to go ahead and export these images. I'm going to select the first one, scroll down to the last one, hold down Shift, click on this one to select all of them in between, and then I'm going to right-click on any of them. I'm going to go down to Export, and then choose Export right over here. And here's the Export dialog box where you can see at the top, I have 8 files selected, and you may be familiar with this dialog box, so I'm not going to go too in-depth with it. But right here, I can choose what folder I want to export it to. I don't want to export it to my iPhone 5S folder. I'm going to choose Lightroom Watermarks. Press choose, and then scrolling down towards the bottom, right down here, you have the option of adding a watermark to those images. I'm going to check this on, and then under this drop-down, you'll see we have the new watermarks that we just created, the text-based watermark and the graphic watermark. I'm going to choose the graphic watermark for this example, and then simply press export. And at the top left, you can see the progress as Lightroom is exporting those images and adding the watermarks. And when the process is complete, that folder is going to open up with all the images that have been exported from Lightroom. And if I click on one of them, press my spacebar, I can see that I now have the watermark at the bottom left-hand corner. And if I scroll through these images, you can see it's on the other ones as well. It's that simple. And because I chose to size the watermark proportionally, it doesn't matter what size the image is, that watermark is going to look fantastic on all of those images. And that's how you can very easily add your own text or image-based watermarks to your photos in Lightroom. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and as always, if you want to be kept up to date on new content, subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, and I'll see you next time for another Photoshop or even Lightroom tutorial. Take care. Thanks again to Squarespace for supporting my content. If you want to start building your website or online portfolio, head over to Squarespace right now. You get 20% off and a completely free trial, no credit card required at all. They have over 20 highly customizable templates. It's really easy to use. And if you need some help, Squarespace has an amazing support team that works 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. But best of all, they're based out of Soho in New York. Starting at just $8 a month, which includes a free domain name, you have nothing to lose. Head over to squarespace.com, sign up for a free trial, and use the coupon code ICEFLOW9 for 10% off.